Oh, the pomp and the pageantry of a great state basketball tournament, Veterans Auditorium in Des Moines, Iowa. And you have sampled something special tonight with us. The 1987 girls state basketball tournament comes to a close with two great basketball games and all the gingerbread that goes with it, because what a night we've had here at Vets Auditorium, and there's more great basketball to come. Out on the floor, the Rams from Southeast Polk. They are number one in the state of Iowa. They are unbeaten in 27 starts this year. And on the other end of the floor, it is Ventura, unbeaten at 30 wins and no losses in 1986-87, featuring the incomparable Lynn Lorenzen. We'll have those introductions in just a bit. Right now, let's head downstairs, and here is Bob Earl.
Hey, thank you very much. Well, what fun we're having up here tonight. You know, it isn't often that many states in the United States can boast of having a woman as its lieutenant governor. Iowa has that honor, and Joanne Zimmerman. Joanne, I'm going to congratulate you on that. You've had a long day. What about this pageant? Does that excite you?
Yes, I've been to a lot of girls' state tournaments, and I'm always spirited in the enthusiasm that you feel on the floor and filling this whole building, and knowing that even though it's televised and it's on the radio, we still fill this building.
Well, I know you come from a basketball background. You played high school basketball.
Yes, I did.
Whereabouts?
I played at Kissaqua High School. That's Van Buren Community Schools now.
Well, I don't think that ended it, did it? Joanne, how about how about the women's league you played in here on Des Moines?
Well, I like the six-girl basketball. It gives you a lot of opportunity to play for the rest of your life, and it gives you a lot of good exercise. And I played in a women's league until 4 years ago, when my schedule became very undependable when I went into the legislature. But it makes good friends and gives you good exercise.
You know, we had a great five-girls tournament here and a great six-girls tournament about to be concluded tonight. I suppose you're happy about girls basketball generally, right?
Oh, yes, I am. We've had really good participation in women's sports in Iowa, and it showed up, you know, in the long run. We've had many, many women from Iowa go on to teams across the United States.
Okay, let's very quickly, in about 30 seconds, have you tell me about what the women's situation in Iowa is. It's really progressing, am I right?
What was the question?
The women's progress in Iowa is really something.
Oh, yes. Throughout the Midwest, I've seen a lot of participation by women in politics. And, in fact, there are 12 women lieutenant governors in the United States, and five of them are in the Midwest. And that comes out of, I think, our rural participation on the farms and working side by side in business with men. And we've made good progress here.
We want to thank Iowa's lieutenant governor, Joanne Zimmerman, for a fine interview. And we're about ready to start the second game here tonight. And here's George Turner.
Six-player championship game coming up. The visiting team on the scoreboard will be the Southeast Polk Rams. Southeast Polk, coached by Ray Svensson, a graduate of Iowa, came to the job in 1986, first year there. The girls this year were Central Iowa Conference champions. His assistant coaches are Gary Fry, Vern King, and Lois Johnson. They're making their sixth trip to the state tournament. They were champs in 1977. They're one of two undefeated teams left. They were the top-rated team in the state. They advanced to tonight's game with wins over Hartley, Melvin, Carroll Kemper, and Mediapolis. Let's welcome the Southeast Polk Rams. And the home team for the six-player championship game, the Ventura Lady Vikes. Ventura, coached by Chuck Bredlow, a graduate of Central College that came to the job in 1982. His assistant coach, Nancy Rodenbeck. The girls this year won the North Star Conference champions, and making their fourth trip to the state tournament, they are undefeated also. They advanced to tonight's game with wins over Lone Tree, Dyke, and Denison. Let's welcome the third-rated Ventura Lady Bikes.
Thank you, George Turner. We'll be ready to go with the 6-on-6 championship game right after this.
There's a new way.
Great taste is coming.
To get all your sows.
Great taste is coming.
To make more milk.
Great taste is here.
It's new Land O'Lakes Sow Maxi Milk. Even the thin sows or first litter gilts love Sow Maxi Milk.
Great taste.
So they eat their way into making more milk. Get new Sow Maxi Milk at your cooperative handling Land O'Lakes feed.
Now let's meet the starting lineups for the six-player championship game. First, for the Southeast Polk Rams, the forwards, number 23, Don Bergeson. Number 31, Betty Flack. Number 55, Heather Adair. The guards, number 13, Stacy Donahoe. Number 43, Michelle Rickenbacker. Number 51, Rhonda Kretschmer. The assistant coaches, Gary Fry. Vern King. And Lois Johnson. And the head coach of the Southeast Polk Rams, Ray Benson. Now the starters for the Ventura Lady Bikes. The forwards, number 50, Lynn Lorenzen. Number 20, Robin Costello. Number 40, Steph Anderson. The guards, number 52, Steph Jacobs. Number 34, Shelley Quinn. Number 44, Jenny Young. The assistant coach, Nancy Rodenbeck. And the head coach of the Ventura Lady Bikes, Chuck Bredlow. The floor officials, Dan Connery and Art Pinker. Bench official, Rich Sampson.
So there you have it. The table is set for the 6-on-6 championship. Number one meets number three. Southeast Polk unbeaten at 27-0. Up against Ventura, unbeaten at 30-0. And number three in the state of Iowa, the Ram backers across the way in their gold and black. And wearing the blue and gold, on the other side of the floor will be the Ventura Lady Bikes backers. And Mike, you'll draw the analogy, David and Goliath once again, the big school against the small school, just 47 girls at Ventura High School, 323 at Southeast Polk.
Hey, and we better hang on tight, because there can be action aplenty in this game starting right now.
There she goes, and that's Lynn Lorenzen with her first shot of the basketball game. She'll get her second right here, but a foul will be called ahead of time. Collapsing on her and picking up the first foul of the game will be Rhonda Kretschmer. And inbounds here. He was not in the act of shooting, so it'll be inbounds for Ventura in the forward court. And conferring on the far sideline.
We're going to take it out on the sideline instead
there
of
you
me.
Are. Yep.
Here's the key right here. The pressure defense of Southeast folks bothered everyone. My question, when you're committed to pressure, can you double team Lynn Lorenzen effectively?
Here's Lorenzen. She shovels it off to Costello. Lorenzen. And she has her first two of this basketball game. Ladies and gentlemen, she's averaging above 62 points per game. And her team, the Lady Vikes from Ventura, averaged better than 100. Now Dawn Bergeson answers for Southeast Polk. And just like that, we're 2-all, just underway with the 6-on-6. Costello gets behind the defense and the foul goes to Rickenbacker. Michelle Rickenbacker. There's Chuck Redlow.
Michelle Ricken. We're going to look at it here. Rick, here we come. Runs a beautiful pass down low to Costello. Maybe shouldn't have taken the dribble. Gone straight. And Rickenbacker, who's maybe been the most impressive guard in the tournament, gets the hack to start with.
On the free throw line, this is Robin Costello. She's the playmaking forward for the Lady Vikes. Steph Anderson and Lynn Lorenzen, the other forward. She makes one of two, Costello, and we've got a 3-2 ball game. Ventura with the upper hand. Good pressure, Ventura. In the forward court defensively, it moves into the forward court for Southeast Polk. Flat. Adair couldn't hang on to it.
Down on the steal.
Now look at this forward court pressure on the guards of Ventura. You're going to see a lot of that tonight, because there's one thing the Ray Swenson likes, and that's pressure up and down the 94 feet.
Another great pass. A great pass.
Great exchange with Anderson on the receiving end. The assist goes to Lorenzen.
That's a girl with 6,679 career points that can pass like that.
And a whole lot of assists to go with it. This is Flack. Across the stripe, that's Steph Jacobs.
And watch for her matchup with Dawn Bergeson to be a real key. We still not sure. Bergeson hurt her hand somewhat last night. She looked good on her first shot.
Understand that Dawn Bergeson, she has the ball here, went for x-rays, and she is heavily bandaged on the finger, but she is in the lineup. Nothing broken, but a jam finger, and how it will affect her shooting, she's averaging 37 points, is another thing altogether. Costello, Anderson.
Turn and go left.
Oh, great head fake and the drive to the bucket with the left-handed layup. Lorenzen has four. 7-2, Southeast Polk on the short end of that score, and here are the forwards for the Rams. Black. And the foul will be whistled on Jacobs, apparently.
I think it's either Jacobs or is it Shelly Quinn? I'm going to wait to look at it. We're going to have Black drive directly into the baseline area. Well, we both could have been right. The girl to the right, 50-34 is the one they got for the foul. Shelly Quinn, her first.
Yep, that's going to be Quinn with her first team foul. Ventura, this is Flack. And as a team, Southeast Polk from the free throw line. 68%. Flack makes one of two. A 4-point lead for Ventura. And into the forward court, that's Jacobs on the exchange with Costello. Lorenzen, the assignment on her is Kretschmer. Anderson, Costello. Oh, boy, back order. Lorenzen.
Now, the ball out of bounds. She cannot penetrate that lane, before the line, center line, before the girl throws the inbound pass. Let's watch this.
Take a
great
look
first
it.
Step quickness. Now watch. She's going to pop right over. She's got her on her hip. When she's got it that way, forget it. Don't foul her and give her three.
That's the bread and butter for Lynn Lorenzen. And on the inbounds, blocked to Adair. It rattles out of bounds. Quinn with the good hands. Jacobs with the good hands. And
they really played the lob well at that end. Secondary help from the weak side was great.
This is Ferguson on the inbound. That's their stock play on the inbound play below the Southeast Polk glass. Ferguson has four. She's into this one, as mentioned, at 37 points per game. Lorenzen comes out high to the left side. Costello. That's Lorenzen. And I've got her three for four from the field. Make that four for five.
I was going to say, I got four for five. She missed the first one and got four in a row.
A six-point lead for Ventura. Southeast poked the ball, and Ferguson answers with the short jumper baseline, six.
What man?
Yeah, that's the last thing that's bothered her here.
Uh-oh, there.
Lorenzen with another assist. Costello with the layup, and that'll be three. 13-7 is the count, and the meter's running, ladies and gentlemen. Number one and number three in the scoring column meeting here. Ventura leading the state. Southeast Polk at number three.
Great block, center Quinn, 34.
Quinn put the clamps on Black, and then Quinn lost the handle. The numbers there just approaching now the midway point of the first quarter.
Look at the anticipation on the Golden Black search in that crowd. That's Southeast Polk crowd, I know that.
Southeast Polk and their road blacks with gold trim at Ventura, and the home whites with blue and gold trim. Costello brings it down against Rickenbacker. Rickenbacker backs away the pass in a line violation.
And that was almost, but we're going to see it if she did violate the line. I'm thirsty to move that angle. I'm not going to see it. She batted it away. Whoops, yes,
here we go.
Are.
Now, if you come in contact with the ball and you're on the line, that is a line violation.
We got Stacy Donahoe.
It's not necessarily, Mike, correct me if I'm wrong, that you have control of the ball. It's just that you're touching it while you're on the line. Costello will handle the inbounds. Lorenzen brings it down. Rickenbacker again, the good hand. Lorenzen recovers. She's got her assist hat on tonight, and she dumps it off to Anderson. Couldn't drop it down.
Nice block, but I think it's heading to our left, to the black shirts. It is.
Now let's see those forwards for Ventura. Put the clamps on and the guard cord up the floor. Donahoe, Rickenbacker. Ferguson brings it down. Now Adair will move to the low post. Black. Oh, a beauty. You betcha. Everybody in the joint was thinking Heather Adair would bring it down and sneak again behind as Ferguson.
That's their version of the alley-oop slam. They can't quite slam it. Oh, look at that one. Mike.
Oh, Lynn Lorenzen has 10. 15-9.
Is she quick enough for you?
Boy, she can move. And the big question is still not answered. Where will she play collegiate basketball? Will it be Arizona? Will it be Penn State? Ohio State? Iowa State? Or Iowa? Been narrowed down to five. That's Heather Adair.
She'll play small forward for somebody awfully well.
She sure will. She moves up and down the floor exceptionally gracefully. And the foul on Donahoe.
Within the last 24 hours, Lynn Lorenzen was named as the first ever girl winner in the Naismith Awards, which are on the ESPN Sports Show and going to be replayed next week. But we just heard that. Just more icing to a great career.
Steph Anderson has four and a six-point lead for Ventura. Here are the Rams in the forward court. Adair. Black. Ferguson. Alley-oop. Gets her own rebound. She's fouled on the way down, and putting the arm in the air will be Jenny Young.
I have that as one team foul against four. Ventura already in the bonus. Oops, that's two. Mike Cowden's not real good.
Oh, Michael will forgive you. It's been a long week, but a delightful week. The inbounds to Ferguson, and she skids on the Knickerbockers after scoring her ninth and tenth points. And this one tightens up a little bit, but not for long. Lorenzen has 12. 19-13, a six-point lead for the ladies in white, the Lady Vikes of Ventura.
I got to remember, that's the defense that stymied every team in the first three rounds.
Ferguson goes against Jacob. A pair of All-State performers right there against each other, and Ferguson is going to win that battle. She's got 12.
He's got 12. Lorenzen's got 12. Ventura's got 19. Southeast Polk's got 15.
And another assist for Lorenzen, another basket for Anderson. Anderson has six. Anderson can put the ball in the hole. She's into this basketball game.
I could have put the ball in the hole from that pass.
That's no. Right. 23.8 is her average. Kind of stands in the shadow of Lynn Lorenzen's 62.8. But I'll tell you this, Chuck Breglow has welcomed each and every point Steph Anderson has put down this year.
The cupboard's not bare when Lynn Lorenzen leaves. All the guards are back. Anderson's back. Remember Kelly Smiley from last night? She's back. Good little shit.
Oh, my goodness. Anderson with eight. Steph Anderson. Ferguson. And the rebound to Jan. Jacobs will get it across the timeline. No, she won't. It's Quinn.
Fasten the seatbelts, guys. This is going to be an offensive show all night.
Oh, yeah.
That's evident right now.
That's Costello working against Rickenbacker. The pick, Lorenzen. And Rickenbacker picks her up off the pick. Costello dumps it to Lynn. The
block.
Yep, it'll be a block. And that's a pretty good coaching strategy. Stacy Donahoe, with no hope of going against the 6-2 Lorenzen, get the body squarely underneath her, you might get the foul.
Right.
This time the whistle goes the other way.
Now, Chuck Breglow wanted the basket there, but it was obvious. The foul was on the pass, not the shot.
Donahoe with
he
her
still
third.
Wants it.
Yep, that's her third personal. Swenson,
and
Ray Swenson going crazy.
Would you believe he got the basket?
He did get the
he
basket.
He got the basket.
14 points for Lynn Lorenzen. That was Lynn Baker, by the way, checking in for Kretzmar. Rhonda Kretzmar. Lynn Lorenzen with 15.
And Ray Swenson is not at all happy about that basket being awarded.
No. Rickenbacker with 15 seconds across the timeline.
26 points in the quarter's not over.
Heather Adair from the baseline. Jacobs the rebound, and that's the end of quarter number one. You betcha. Ventura with the upper hand, 26-15 on Southeast Polk. We'll move on to quarter number two right after this.
These co-op tires are covered by a 60-month field hazard warranty. 60 months. Shoot, Uncle Harley met a woman, got married, had three kids, got divorced, moved to Alaska, struck gold, and retired in Tahiti in less time than that. 60 months. If something happens to a tire that can't be fixed, I get a new one, and all I have to pay for is the time I use the old one. Good tires, too. Yesterday, I ran over a steel fence post, hit a stump, backed over my new arc welder, and the tires are fine. Arc welder's a mess, though.
Veterans Memorial Auditorium, Des Moines, Iowa. And you're in tune with the 1987 Girls State Basketball Championship. We've had a long night of activity, a long week of activity. The huddle on the fireside, the Lady Vikes of Ventura checking in with Chuck Breglow. They have a lead at this point of 11 points. And on the other side, Ray Svensson is trying to adjust.
What a first quarter that was. 26-15, Ventura. Lynn Lorenzen showed an awfully lot of the different things she can do. She doesn't only score the 6,700 career points, her passing, her movement without the ball, her forward court defense.
7 of 8 from the field, Lorenzen.
But look at the team.
86% from the field, 12 of 14 is Ventura in the first quarter. Southeast Polk, 7 of 15 for 47%. An 11-point lead, Ventura. 13. And Lorenzen has 17 points. And now Southeast Polk will try to regroup here. This is Clapp. Ferguson the rebound, gets it stripped away, and that was Steph Jacobs. Steph Anderson. Lorenzo, the assist.
Nope. Got to go in first.
The rebound in the basket. That's right. You can't get the assist until you get the basket. 19.
We might get a technical this time. We will. After the first warning for violating the circle, the second one you're going to get a technical on. And it's called correctly. That was...
All righty.
It's a player technical. One shot.
All right. That's a good call. Good call.
I'm glad we had the backing of Chuck Redlow on that call. Yeah, he agreed with us. I think he said it loud enough so the officials would hear it.
That's
too,
right. I think there was a message in that message. This is Ferguson. She doesn't miss many. But so on the technical.
So there's no harm on the situation. They had the ball anyway.
7-11. Oh, we've got our Hall of Fame presentation coming up at halftime.
You know who's going to give those? Your friend and mine.
That's right, Jim Duncan. Professor Duncan will be on hand. Flack off the shoe, and Ray Swenson is trying to solve the puzzle.
He might make that.
That's a good point.
Look at Ferguson go on defense.
Up the floor, Jenny Young. Costello. Lorenzen. Oh, you just can't come up with a superlative for this young lady. I'll tell you that. That was Steph Anderson on the receiving end from Lynn Lorenzen. Timeout has been called with 6:50 remaining in the second. Ventura 32. Southeast Polk 15 will return right after this.
When it comes to weaning, we've made some significant gains. Land O'Lakes research has discovered the best way to get little pigs off milk is to feed them milk. Just put litter milk alongside their starter feed the first 4 days of weaning, and your pigs will be 5 pounds heavier right out of the nursery. Combination weaning. Another new idea from Land O'Lakes.
Here we go. Take a look at this assist.
Looks like here it is to Lorenzen easy, but look at that eyesight. Where's Steph Anderson? That's another one Mike Newell could make.
Oh, look at that.
How did you like it? We were wondering here. Wondering how, when the last time that a team didn't go into a total double or even triple team on Lynn. She's loving this because she's got the opportunity to move around to show some of her skills without two guards on her the entire time.
Inbounds, here's Southeast Polk. Ferguson answers, and she has 14. And that'll narrow the gap a little bit. It was a 17-point lead in the early going. Lorenzen again off to Costello. That's Lynn Baker with the assignment on Lorenzen. Rickenbacker has the assignment on Costello.
That's the first turnover caused by the pressure. Had one in the guard court, but that's the first forward court turnover.
That's Baker. Rickenbacker. Three fine guards for Southeast Polk. Best three in the state for my money. They can really chase that ball. And here's another one who can run it down, and that is Steph Jacobs, the interception. Lorenzen gets the boards, and traveling will be called. And by the way, we're going to be talking about Lynn Lorenzen all night. Keep in mind there's nine other players on the floor with her, but Chuck Redlow knows this. Lynn has fans watching in Mesa, Arizona via satellite tonight of our fine broadcast. Carlo Fernandez, our producer director, Bob Scarpino, putting together the program, and everybody's enjoying it that way down in Mesa. More fans in Creswell, Oregon. Well, Lynn's got fans all over. She did win the Naismith Award.
And that sister that you're talking about was played on the state tournament team for Dyser Geneseo a few years back. All three of the sisters played in the state tournament, plus both of her mother's daughters, Clausen kids from Applington. So five different daughters of the fabulous Billerbeck twins have played in state tournament competition.
Kelly Cobb is the newcomer in the guard court lineup for Ventura. The inbounds, Ferguson. Quinn the rebound. Jenny Yan goes to the bench with a total of two personals.
Oh, I just got a nice note from Steve Rowe on our fine stats crew over here. On all six of Ventura's field goals that Lynn didn't score, she was awarded an assist for.
Boy, she's a statistical chase, isn't she? Just keep.
Hey, that's a challenge for this Drake University stats crew to keep up. It really is.
This is Lynn Lorenzen. She doesn't miss many from the stride, shooting 73% from the free throw line and 77% from the field. Lorenzo now with 21.
Jeff Anderson can have that if he wants it.
Second 17-point lead of the ball game. Ventura, Costello,
that's
Lorenzo.
19.
And that's 23 points for Lynn Lorenzo. 5:30 remaining. Second quarter play, the 1987 girls six-on-six championship. And the foul to the newcomer in the lineup, that's Kelly Cobb.
Kelly had a fine first-round effort against Sloan 3 and very limited action. She had four steals.
Replacement in the lineup for Southeast Polk. Lynn Baker is back on, so it's Baker, Kretschmar, and Rickenbacker in the guard court for Southeast Polk. The guards now for Ventura, Jacobs, Quinn, and Cobb. And she gets a couple here. Betty Flack now with three.
Look at that forward guard defense.
Great defensive pressure. The forwards putting the clamps on for Southeast Polk. And that's the way it's been all year. That's the way Ray coaches it. Pressure all over the floor. Ferguson on the inbound.
16 for her.
Oh, the meter's running on that into the floor as well. Costello, the assist. Lorenzo the basket.
One thing that makes her particularly effective against pressure is she can go backwards for the lob or come forward for the other. This time she's going to go backwards for the lob. Here we go. Costello into Anderson. Now we see. Lynn's got her on the hold. That was a fast move.
That's a quick pass.
Was that a pretty quick first step for Lorenzo? You're going to get her on the Olympic team now.
On the other end of the floor, that's Betty Flack. Now with 5 points. A third 17-point lead for Ventura. And now it's number four. That's Costello. She has 5. 40-23. Ventura leading Southeast Polk. The Lady Vikes leading the Rams. Black, Ferguson, and Adair, the forward court. Good feed, Ferguson, Adair on the receiving end, and Adair has 4.
That's unbelievable. Adair is a 30-point game scorer. I thought against the smaller guards, he would go to work.
Well, it hung on the lip a little while, but it dropped just the same, 27.
I think that's 11 straight after missing her first in the field. I think she's 11 of 12 with the last 11 in a row. No, 12 with 13, 12 in a row. Plus 3 free throws would be 27, wouldn't it?
There you go. Ferguson, good hang time, and Clack brings it down. Jacobs underneath is whistled on the foul.
Now the East Polk coach, Ray Swenson, of course, won the 1985 state championship 2 years ago with his Fort Dodge team. He hasn't lost in 29 plus 27, 56 straight games under the six-player rules.
There's a shot of Ray. And here's a shot of Betty Flack. .341 remains to the halftime break. She gets a couple out of it. I've got her 5 for 5 from the free throw line and now 7 points. It's a 15-point lead. Ventura with the lead in the ball. Steph Anderson. 12 points. For Anderson. Here's Heather Adair. Ferguson down low pulls the trigger. She's got 18. Lorenzen. Anderson. And the rebound goes to Lynn Baker.
Now's the time for Southeast Polk to make up some of the difference.
This is Black at the baseline, gets it to drop, and shots will be coming. The arm goes in the air. Jenny Yan, I've got her for three.
I do too, and that's one of the toughest moves in basketball. We're going to look at it. Here comes Flax. He's going to get right on the baseline, coming to the basket. That's a hard shot, and she makes it as she's fouled by Yan, and that is her third.
Yan did a good job getting around the pick, but she had some catching up to do, and she was backpedaling at the same time. Flack does get the three-pointer out of it. She's got 10.
Six straight from the line.
Now a 12-point ball game, and Southeast Polk chiseling away at the lead. Ventura will have something to say about that right here with Costello and Lorenzen. Gets the pick. And the feed, great exchange. Three-player offense right there.
And that was made by the pick of Robin Costello. It was the thing that really made the play, even though the pass was great to Steph Anderson. Same pick at the other end, by Ferguson.
Steph Anderson with 14. Ferguson, Adair. Took its time. Oh, the fan in the stand. All the black and gold on the fireside, Southeast Polk. Lorenzen kept the ball alive and got it back to Anderson, and Anderson gets it back to Lorenzen.
And we got the entire Southeast Polk coaching staff up on that one, all four of them.
Lady Vike cheerleaders on the sideline.
Good job on your pick.
Here's Flack. Boy, she's getting sharp late here in the second quarter. She's got 12 with a 130 remaining in the half, and here's Lorenzen answering for Ventura. 31 points, Lynn Lorenzen. A 14-point lead, Ventura. Southeast Polk with the ball.
Jenkins was playing that extremely well. She fronted her, timed her leap, just it perfect. Caused Ferguson to not be able to get to the lob.
Jenny Yan back on with three personals to replace Kelly Cobb.
That surprises me with three fouls. I thought they'd leave her out there for a minute, eight.
Especially this late in the half. Lorenzen on the breakaway.
Is he going to get a foul on that one?
Lorenzen pushing off. She got her own rebound, put it back in the air. Well, Lynn's one of those players that you're going to discuss a foul with, I guess.
Yeah.
That's her first.
That's the call the Southeast Polk coaching staff wanted on the last one.
Ray Svensson helping out with the call on the fireside. Chuck Fredlow for the Lady Vikes, and here's Ferguson. Well, we had an all-state shortstop performer in the first game, and here's a shortstop turned third baseman who could be an all-state candidate, Ferguson. And we missed the shortstop moving on further in the turn in from Ankeny.
And this is an important thing, because Ventura has to work it out of this guard court now. The lead that was sitting on 17 and 15 has now cut down to 14 and 12. One more turnover could get it onto the single figures.
Ferguson now with 20. 45 seconds and counting.
We got it, too. 3 seconds. And that was the 3-second line violation on Lorenzen, not the 3-second holding the ball violation.
Kretschmeyer with the inbounds assignment. Here's Rickenbacker. Ferguson brings it down. Jacobs puts the pressure on her. Now Adair from behind. Jacobs rattles it loose, and she's whistled on the foul. Steph Jacobs gets her second. Good, aggressive guard performer.
To me, the most amazing thing about the first half of the ball game is the Ventura guards primarily have about taken Heather Adair out of the offense. She only has 6 points.
Quinn the rebound, and up the floor, Lorenzen. We go to the forward court for the Lady Vikes. Good move to the basket, and she's fouled along the way, Kretschmeyer. She made daylight where there was no daylight, and 33 points now for Lorenzen.
I ran out of second quarter space on my scoreboard a long time ago. I'm on the second line and almost to it. I say 19 this quarter.
You won't miss many of those either. And the rebound goes to Steph Anderson, but she's called for traveling. And so now the guard court will bring it in for Southeast Polk. 20 seconds remain. A 14-point lead, Ventura, 52-38. Adair down low, gets one to drop. She's got eight. Now a 12-point ball game. Lorenzen from three-point range. But they gave her two. As the first half comes to a close. 35 points for Lorenzen.
He signaled two, and they think they put three on the board. I'm going to go with 54 from the signal, but the board does show 55. We're going to maybe see on the line here.
You be the judge. Let's take a look. Lorenzen, yep, her feet are on that three-point line.
I say no, and the board agrees with us.
All
the
righty.
Official score is 54-40.
There are the numbers. Ventura leading Southeast Polk at the half, and we'll be back with the Hall of Fame Awards presentation right after this.
Running a tractor on ordinary diesel fuel is kind of like eating cafeteria chili. Just no spunk to it. But with Fieldmaster TQ4 diesel fuel, I get spunk to spare. Oh, I've run some other diesel fuels through my tractors, but it just don't get the power. Get a lot more smoke, though. Get a lot more work hours out of the tank of Fieldmaster TQ4, too. Quicker starts. Quicker warm-ups.
Small objects, like cards, coins, and even...
Now for the presentation of the 1987 inductees into the Hall of Fame, we go to the floor and Jim Duncan.
Thank you, George. The presentation tonight will be done by Mrs. Louise McCormick, a member of the board of directors of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. Tonight, as we present the inductees with their Vicky Award, named after the word for victory, Victoria in Latin, we honor the millions of Iowa girls who have brought this game to national prominence. In all, 82 different Iowa girls have made first All-America, and they made that honor a collective total of 130 times. 12 girls have been named first All-America while they were still in high school. And this is the most astounding statistic of all. Iowa has had a first All-America for 33 straight years. Recently, the Women's Basketball News Service selected the top 50 players of the country. There were four from Iowa. No other state had more except for California, that had six, and the population of California is over nine times the population of Iowa. The year is 1980. A girl from Britt is the toast of the state tournament. She scores 209 points for the fourth highest total of all time. She's captain of the all-tournament team, and she finishes her career with over 4,000 points. She goes to the University of South Dakota. Three times she is all North Central Conference in both volleyball and basketball. And in basketball, she's the MVP of the conference in 1982. A math major, she is named in her senior year second All-America academic. She wins the Stan Marshall Award. This coveted award is given to the North Central Conference's outstanding student athlete. With South Dakota, she goes to Germany and wins 7 out of 8 games and averages over 20 points. Now a math teacher and assistant coach at Clear Lake, the Hall of Famer from Britt, 1980, Kerry Wallen. The year is 1979. One of the most versatile athletes in Iowa history is drawing her career to the close. She has won the state 100-meter hurdles championship. She's the All-State first team third baseman in softball, and she's captain of the all-tournament basketball team playing for East Des Moines that has the largest victory margin of all time, winning four games by an average of over 29 points a game. She goes to Midland in Nebraska. There she is named second All-America, NAIA, in basketball, and competing in the grueling seven-event heptathlon, she is a national NAIA champion. When Nebraska names the leading college athlete of the year, for the first time in 37 years, it is a woman, and it's this athlete here tonight. Now, Mrs. Brad Rogge of Sandusky, Ohio, an elementary teacher and an assistant coach at St. Mary's of Sandusky, the East High Des Moines Hall of Famer, 1979, Kerry Cramme. The year is 1981. A girl from Earlham gets to the state tournament for the first time, and she scores 113 points in two games. She has been the leading scorer of the state in 1980. And when Converse picks its All-America teams that year, she's one of the 21 honorable mentions. She leads the state again in scoring in 1981. And this time she's named Converse First All-American High School. She goes on to Simpson. Three times at Simpson, she is named to the first team in the All-America selection, both by AIAW and by the Kodak NCAA College Division. She is one of the seven players in Iowa history to make All-America four different times. She's one of the six to ever lead the state in scoring twice. Of the millions who have played, she is the only one ever to do both. Now, Mrs. Danwood of Monroe, a physical education and health teacher and assistant coach at Pleasantville, the Hall of Famer from Earlham, 1981, Lori Sankey. Your Hall of Fame, 1987. And now, if you will turn so the other folks can see you from the other side, very good, thank you. The Hall of Fame, 1987.
When I go to work, the only thing open around these parts are my eyes. That's why the boys down at the co-op gave me a key to the gas pumps. Well, sort of. Actually, they're card activated. So when I do need fuel at some ungodly hour, all I do is pull into the pump, run my card through a reader, punch in my number, and bingo, I'm pumping gas or diesel. Yep, you got to get up early in the morning to get ahead of this old boy. Especially if you're a bass.
There's a new way.
Great taste is coming.
To get all your sows.
Great taste is coming.
To make more milk.
Great taste is here.
It's new Land O'Lakes Sow Maxi Milk. Even the thin sows or first litter gilts love Sow Maxi Milk.
Great taste.
So they eat their way into making more milk. Get new Sow Maxi Milk at your cooperative handling Land O'Lakes feed. Tonight's broadcast of the Iowa State High School Girls Basketball Finals is being brought to you for the 28th year by your cooperative and Land O'Lakes.
We're very happy to have with us tonight a man who's been here for 9 consecutive years, U.S. Senator Charles Grassley from Iowa. Senator, what are the main topics in Washington these days?
Oh, I think trade legislation's the hottest issue over the next 4 or 5 months. And then after that, the farm credit system and what to do with it and how to protect the farmer. And then the question of whether or not the farm bill will be opened up.
Let's start with the farm bill. What are the chances something will be done this year, do you think?
Well, I don't think it'll be opened up because the House of Representatives very much opposes opening it up. And frankly, with the president requesting a 10% cut in price support, I hope it isn't opened up because I don't think we can afford to take a chance on losing that debate.
And then the middle issue of farm credit.
Well, the farm credit will have to have some help. It'll get some help, but the system's not going to get the help. The farmers are going to get the help, and we're going to protect stockholders' rights and see that the help that we give filters down to the farmer instead of stopping with the system.
And how about trade? Is there any move or mood in this country towards protectionism as far as trade?
Well, there is a mood towards that. I think we'll pass some legislation that will be read that way, but I don't think it'll be very protectionist in the final analysis, but I think it will help us turn our trade deficit around.
Okay. Thank you very much, Senator. And now to Mike Newell.
Well, thank you, Don Mum, and thank you very much, Senator Charles Grassley, a great women's basketball fan. I'm Mike Newell. This is Mike Henderson, and we're your play-by-play host for a great night of basketball. Here in Des Moines, we're just about set to put 8 more minutes up on the board for quarter number 3. And, Mike, we said it a little bit earlier, the meter is running, 54 points on the board in the first 16 minutes. For Ventura, Southeast Polk with 40 on the board. And you know, if you push a pencil around the paper long enough and you see that 101 point per game average for Ventura, they average better than 3 points per minute.
Oh, it's been incredible. Just a couple of more numbers. Lorenzen went over 6,700 career points in that half. Ran her tournament total in the 4 games to 218. They're running 16. She's got the tournament scoring lead wrapped up. However, she can't get the all-time record, which is 282 by the legendary Denise Long in the 1968 tournament.
Forward court to our right, and this is Southeast Polk to open the second half. Ferguson on the feed from Flack, and she gets the first two of the second half after a 20-point first half.
Important basket, too.
Yes. And a 12-point lead, Ventura getting the hand on it, Rickenbacker, and going elbow over earlobe across the stripe on the far side is Lorenzen trying to keep the ball alive.
I know who's going to get that ball.
Yep. And Costello runs it down. Great guard court pressure you will see from Southeast Polk. And there's some of it right there. Rickenbacker, Michelle Rickenbacker, playing like an all-stater.
We're going to look at the matchup. I think they switched her over to Lorenzen. At least it looked like a matchup.
Ferguson takes the drive, and the foul will be called in the guard court for Ventura, putting the arm in the air with number 4 is Jenny Young. Oh, Ray's sweating bullets right about at this hour.
And this was, I think, his key. Get it under 8, keep going after it. Get it under 10, keep going after it. Don't panic and try and get it all at once back. The team's not going to lose much with 80.6% shooting in the half. That's what Ventura was, 25 at 31. Southeast Polk was 16 of 28 for 57.1%.
Don Ferguson. And there's Chuck Fredlow. Boy, that time up in the clock looks like an eternity to him, doesn't it?
Is he sitting there with John Overton watching the free throw on the monitor?
I think he is. Got the best seat in the house. Boy, Ferguson misses a couple. This is Jacob. And into the forward court, Ventura working to our left.
Yes, Rickenbacker is on Lorenz.
Head fake and the drive. And the assist to Lorenzen, the basket for Anderson, and Anderson with 16. It was a 39-point second quarter for Ventura. And that's Black, 14. Yep, a 39-point second quarter, and they built four 17-point leads.
You've caught me with four mathematical games in this errors in this game, so I'm not going to mind catching you. 54 minus 26 equals 29.
Oh, I had 15. I was had this score on the wrong side of the board.
I think I have it wrong, too. How about 28?
You caught us. You caught me, and then you caught yourself, didn't you?
Anyway, back to basketball, what you said.
That's right.
Lorenzen to Anderson again.
Yep. Anderson now with 18. That's Black. And she has 16. Betty Black may be the margin of difference. Ferguson has 22. Black with 16. And Donahoe will put the arm in the air here. Stacy Donahoe, and I've got her for four, but the reason I say she may be the margin of difference, you can count on 37 a game from Ferguson. And what sort of supporting...
Oh, she can't catch that.
Yeah, but the support that she gets behind her is going to be most important, just like the support behind Lorenzen. Chuck Fredlow sees Rickenbacker take the rebound down, and 5:30 remains in the third, 60-46. 14-point lead for Ventura, and it's down to 12 again with Ferguson's jump shot, and she has 24. Too far for Lorenzen, and Rickenbacker picks it up. Adair.
The next big hill is getting into double play, into single figures.
Adair on the turnaround, and tracking it down is...
Oh,
Betty Black to take away Jacobs, and she'll be whistled on the foul. It was a foot raise to the ball. Black won it. But as she came up with it, Jacobs got a piece of it, and she's whistled on the foul. Let's take it
away. There we come. They're pretty close. Close. She gets control. Guess what? She's going to
come back.
Here's
where the foul comes.
Boom.
Right there. Guess who's behind you?
And boom.
And that'll be three personals for Scott Jacobs. Ferguson. And Flack runs it down. 4:35 remain. A 12-point ball game. Flack with the follow shot makes it a 10-point ball game.
I think Coach Chuck Redlow would give that basket. He was worried about a foul on Jacob.
Yep. Costello, Lorenzen, and Anderson.
We're going to have an undercut on looking at it. Boy, she's working hard. I think she's been the best guard in the tournament, Mike. No question in my mind.
You aren't going to get any argument for me, Mike, because I've seen her now in four straight games, and I'm amazed.
That's right. You've been on the late night shift, haven't you?
That's right.
Southeast Polk never wore their light uniforms in tournament play. They were the home team, the bottom bracketed team every night.
Rickenbacker now with a couple.
She's going to get another one.
Whoop. And that'll be number three. She's doing hand-to-hand combat with the number one scorer of all time, Lynn Lorenzen. It's a big assignment. Look at Rickenbacker. Lorenzen at 6'2". And Rickenbacker at 5'7". And Rickenbacker the steal. Lynn Baker is into the guard court. She gets it across the timeline. And with a 10-point game here, Mike, you mentioned single figures. Might happen right here. Jacobs the rebound. Black triggers from 15. Lorenzen, Costello, Lorenzen. Second basket of the half for Lorenzen. She has 39. Heather Adair. The feed from Flack. First basket for Adair in the second. She has 10. And Chuck Bredlow. Sees a 10-point lead on the board, and he wants more. Lorenzen again from the low post feed out front from Costello. Black will let the flow catch up here. Has your rebounders in position. Doesn't need them. 20 for Black. Her average, by the way, into this one is 18.4. She's above it. Got away, and Baker comes up with the steal. Lorenzen on the double turnover, tracks it down at midcourt.
We got Robin Costello fell over the line right after the collision. Number 20.
Line violation, Costello.
Why do you want to force it?
That's right. Play your game now, and that's what Heather Adair does on the other side of the ledger. She has 12, and this, my friends, is an 8-point ball game. Now it gets interesting.
Now the next ones get it under 5. Can't try and get it all at once.
Anderson, the follow-away on the feed from Lorenzen. That's 20. And we're back up to 10 points with 2 minutes remaining in the third period. And the battle there, and it pinballs across the timeline, and Ferguson, you saw Ferguson skid across the line, and she went undetected. She got up in a hurry and retreated.
Well, there were 8 people chasing the ball at full speed,
right.
Both officials and the 6 girls at that end. Definitely Jacobs did hit the ball out.
All we need is a soccer goalie, and we've got a heck of a game on our hands here. Rickenbacker up the floor. We'll bring it down to Ferguson. Jacobs is on her. Now Adair. High post, and she'll exchange and go low here. Black on the drive. Betty Black has 22 points.
Black's having a career tonight.
66-58. 1:15 remaining in the third. Ventura the lead and the ball. That was Lynn Baker with the steal, and Lynn Lorenzen playing catch-up will get her second foul of the basketball game. Timeout on the floor. 1:11 remaining in the third. Ventura, 66. Southeast Polk, 58. Hang on to your rabbit ears. We'll return right after this.
Land O'Lakes Litterween, the great-tasting pig starter that can actually help you eliminate post-weaning lag. Because research proves pigs prefer Litterween 4-to-1 over other top starters. Stop by your local cooperative handling Land O'Lakes products for the taste pigs prefer 4-to-1, at least. Land O'Lakes Litterween, available at your Cenex or Land O'Lakes affiliated cooperative.
Let's listen to the message from Chuck Bredlow.
You gotta come back now, people. Here we go.
We gotta come back.
We didn't miss much of the message. That's what the whole timeout was about.
Use your elbows, Lynn.
That's what I thought I heard, too, Michael.
You don't score 6,000 and change without using him. And that's Adair on the inbound. Quim, the rebound. Let's go the other way. And take a look at that forward court pressure. The guards for Ventura fighting him off. Five steals in the third quarter thus far for the Southeast Polk contingent.
And they didn't force a one in the first half.
That's Lorenzo on a beautiful fade from Costello.
Body controls. He was hung under the basket on that move. Still got it in.
43 points. Ferguson against Jacobs. Ferguson will get the assist. A dare in the basket. Inside of 20 seconds remaining in the third. And it's an 8-point ball game. That'll be Lynn Baker. Well, that's a lot of talent off the bench for Ray Svensson.
You realize Ventura has missed one shot this quarter, and they still lost 6 points off their halftime lead.
Lorenzen couldn't get it to drop. That's Rickenbacker, the rebound. An 8-point ball game, and Southeast Polk with 2 seconds, 1 second, would like to make it. No, it will not count. All righty. We go to the fourth and final quarter. It's Ventura 68, Southeast Polk 60. We'll be back for our final 8 minutes in just a moment.
When I go to work, the only thing open around these parts are my eyes. That's why the boys down at the co-op gave me a key to the gas pumps. Well, sort of. Actually, they're card activated. So when I do need fuel at some ungodly hour, all I do is pull into the pump, run my card through a reader, punch in my number, and bingo, I'm pumping gas or diesel. Yep, you got to get up early in the morning to get ahead of this old boy. Especially if you're a bass.
Chuck Redlow.
Moving out the ball. Moving around. Coming to it. Just come to the ball. No, we ain't running the elbow rotation.
We missed something last time. Elbow rotation is the name of one of their offenses. he says, get your elbow up. He said, elbow rotation. He
goes, there you go.
That's their offensive form of coming and moving away from the ball, coming out. I know what it is.
There has to be an explanation. On the inbounds, that'll be Ferguson with the shot, and Ferguson with their first personal. Just underway in the fourth and final. And the Sweet 16, the curtain is coming down.
And we're not in the bonus yet.
Not quite yet. Inbounds to Steph Jacobs. This is Jenny Yan. Pressuring the ball to the forward court for Southeast Polk. Into the forward court for Ventura. Lorenzen out to the high post. The exchange, Anderson. Yes, indeed, she has 22.
I think that was the elbow rotation.
70 to 60. Ventura the lead. Southeast Polk the ball. Ferguson back in the air on the misfire by Flack. 26 points, Don Ferguson. Go with the bread and butter down in the trenches, and that's Lynn Lorenzen with 45 points. And we're back up to a 10-point spread. 6:50 remaining. Jacobs the rebound. Costello. Lorenzen works against Rickenbacker. Anderson against Donahoe. And Lorenzen works the baseline.
And against everybody.
Mm-hmm. 6:16 remaining in this basketball game. Ray Svensson wants to talk it over. It's a 12-point lead for Ventura. Ventura 74, Southeast Polk 62, Ray Svensson.
But there's still 6 minutes. All we got to do is trim 2 points a minute. Okay, lots of time. 2 points a minute, but we let up. You're getting tired? Anybody need a rest? All right, let's get out on it then, okay? Let's get after it. You let them pass around down there. All right, match it up. Problem.
Chuck Bredlow, how about you?
The boards, all right? That's what's hurting you right now. Okay, now listen, now listen. Offensively. Elbow winger pick, you understand? You're doing a nice job. Just jam and go step with each pass. Look. Okay, get a good one. All right? Come here. Yeah, with Robin. Hey, if you never believed before, you better believe now.
Let's do it! Oh, Chuck Bredlow. Boy, he's following the script, isn't he?
Hey, they're getting after it down there.
That's right. We are inside of the final 6 minutes.
And the optimist says that's 2 points a minute.
That's right. Ray Svensson liked that championship up in Fort
Dodge. Whoa, three-pointer already.
Locked with the rebound. Had a great Fort Dodge team, Svensson did, and that's Black with her 23rd and 24th. There's Ray. And he takes over for Bob Urkel at Southeast Polk, and what a program they have going there. But right now, they're looking uphill. The Rams are at a 10-point deficit against a great Ventura team under the direction of Chuck Bredlow. And Lorenzen again. Adair. And Platt. Good hang time for Bergeson, and Quinn will get the foul. Shelly Quinn, it's her second.
She's kind of a quiet guard that just continues to do a good job throughout the game. And here we got Black coming to the middle, as she often does so well. Got her on the arm. Ventura's fortunate that shot didn't fall. Bergeson was squared up really well.
Bergeson has missed three straight from the free throw line. She has a heavily taped small finger. She jammed it, sprained it last night in the semifinal. Ferguson has 27. 76-65. Ventura the lead. Ventura the ball. Third-rated Lady Vikes averaging 100 points and change per game. And Lorenzen, who's
just one incredible athlete, Mike. It seems like we've talked about her an awful lot, but you can't say too much. Just watch your video. We can shut up. You can see what kind of player she is.
Bergeson. Jacob chases it across the baseline, and Bergeson will get her second. You know, when we do talk about Lynn Lorenzen, we do have to remind ourselves that you're watching history, because she is the most prolific scorer of all time, ever.
Yes, and the history she broke was one no one else ever came close to by an Iowan, which stood for 18 years. Denise Long, 6,250 points for Union Witten. No one else came close until Lynn Lorenzen arrived on the scene.
Flying to the state tournament in three of her four high school years. Lynn Lorenzen. Boy, the focus, the national spotlight came her way early on this season at both Ventura and in Mason City to catch her to break the record, and she handles the publicity and the attention so very well.
Blocked by Quinn. And Chuck Bedlow says, you're going to believe now.
4:20 remains, 78-65 at Ventura with the ball and a 13-point lead.
No way she could get to that ball. No way that she could get to that basketball.
She did, and she has 53, and now a 15-point lead. You got to realize Ventura is beating the number one team in the state of Iowa. That's Betty Flack. Both are unbeaten.
You know what we haven't mentioned, and I don't even think it's played a part of the ball game. Ventura's 47-year-old Southeast Coast 400.
That's Lorenzen again.
We've never mentioned it. I'm kind of glad we have it. It hasn't had
the lady, the lady version of David and Goliath, 47 girls at Ventura, and 323 at Southeast Polk. And when it comes to state basketball, Mike, how many great David and Goliath matchups can you remember? Some great ones over the years. Here's Steph Anderson with 24.
Now I can see why Chuck Redlow wanted Steph Anderson in the offense the first three games. She's responded, has 24.
Ferguson, 3:10 remains.
And we can see the biggest lead of the ball game come up right now. Can't wait.
That's right.
Yep, if not the turnovers. I think we had 3:17 in half number one.
And 3 seconds is the violation. The lane violation.
Robin Costello is lumping. They're bringing Kelly Smiley into the lineup. I don't know how she does against the pressure. We know how she shoots the ball.
Little Kelly Smiley. We'll talk about her in just a moment because we've got a timeout right here with 3 minutes exactly remaining. Ventura 84, Southeast Polk 67. We'll return right after this.
You live long enough to see history start to repeat itself. Some years back out here in the country, business started turning sour. Banks went belly up. Crop prices hit rock bottom, and farms went on the block. Then some folks got together and decided to start a business of their own. A business run for and by people who live and work right here in the country. It's called cooperating. Turns out, still a real good idea.
Ray Swenson breaks the huddle.
Well, somebody said he's not talking. I know Ray Swenson pretty well. There's not very many times he's not talking or not thinking.
Chuck Redlow.
You know what they're saying. 3 minutes, 3 minutes, 3 minutes to go. I wonder what for.
That's right. You're 180 seconds away from a state championship for Ventura High School. This is Quinn.
No.
Take a look at these numbers, Mike.
that's the number one team in the state. She's got those numbers again.
That's right.
For at least 2 minutes and 40-some seconds, that's the number one team in the state.
We might be seeing the three-point offense of Ray Swenson.
That girl can shoot him, too.
This is Ferguson. Jacobs, the rebound. Boy, what a job she's done in this tournament.
You know, it's a shame the kid hasn't gotten many numbers on the board, but she's just been in the middle of every battle in four games. The kid that could be left off the all-tournament team just because he didn't have the big rebound or steal.
Smiley came off the bench. She wears number 10, smallest player on the floor. She came off the bench last night to spell Robin Costello and hit a number of key baskets in Ventura's semifinal victory over Denison.
And she's not one bit basket. You'll see.
Lorenzen again. She has 57. 155 and counting. Black on the drive right side. 28 points for Betty. Some anxious moments now on the sideline for Southeast Polk. Lorenzen again. 59 points.
6,734 points right now. Amazing.
Almost incomprehensible. Ferguson once. And Quinn struggling to get off the floor gets rid of it. 114, 113, 110. That's where we are, 70 seconds away. And the foul will be called on Lorenzen. Jeez, come on, give me a break.
No, I've watched you play enough times. I've watched you foul out again. Her first reaction is always me, hand up.
Yeah. Rickenbacker was there at the right time. Here's Don Ferguson. 64 seconds remain in this one. And we're at 1 minute. Smiley. Lorenzen. Anderson. 26 for Steph. 45 seconds remain. 90-69. Ventura the lead. The ball to Southeast Polk. That's Flack from three-point range. You can light up that Red Auerbach cigar pretty quick here, Mike.
It looks like both teams have the scoring benches full.
Smiley.
I hope they get a chance to get Lynn out of here. This house will rock if the clock ever stops.
13, 12, 11, and 10. Lorenzo.
I hope it's an offensive foul. It is. I hope it is. Because the young lady deserves this.
9 seconds remain. Lynn Lorenzo steps out of the lineup.
Look at the house.
The most prolific scorer of all time.
Chuck's very concerned. But he got some stuff on the play. He said, hey, guys, there's 9 seconds left. We haven't won it yet.
hey, here in the gun, Portmeyer. Hurry up.
Chuck says, I want to get this over with and make it official.
I think for the great relays, I'm going to have Steve Rowe hire Chuck for security. He does a pretty good job of clearing the floor.
Kelly Meyer checking in at Ventura's guard court. Five seconds.
To get on with the presentation of the trophies. You would clear the floor, please.
The tears tell the story here at Veterans Memorial Auditorium. Ventura beats Southeast Polk, and here now, George Turner.
Now let's go to the floor for the presentation of the all-tournament team. We go to Jim Duncan.
Thank you, George Turner. The team selected by the sports writers and sportscasters at this tournament. The guards, Michelle Rickenbacker, Southeast Polk. Michelle Snyder Dennison. Jana Masner, Mediapolis. Kim Pudence, Carol Kemper.
Congratulations.
The forwards, Jan Jensen, Elkhorn Kimbleton. Johnson Dennison. Don Bergeson, Southeast Park. And the captain of the all-tournament team, selected today by the Atlanta, Georgia Tip-Off Club for the Naismith Award to the Outstanding Basketball Player of the United States, Lynn Lorenzo Ventura.
Now for the presentation of the traditional red coat to a championship coach. The coach of the only undefeated team left in Iowa from the Ventura Lady Vikes, Chuck Bredlow. Center circle, please, Chuck. And for the presentation of the trophies, I'd like to call once again on the president of the board of directors of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union, the superintendent at North Fayette, Don Mueller.
In another terrific state championship final, let's give a warm welcome to the state champion 1987 runner-up, Coach Ray Svensson and Southeast Polk Lions. And the 1987 state champions, Coach Chuck Bredlow and the Ventura Lady Vikes.
It's the Ventura scoring machine, and the guy at the throttle is Chuck Bredlow. Congratulations to you, Chuck. It's been a great season.
Oh, it's been just unbelievable. It's been something that's just, it's a dream come true, and having the greatest player in the nation. Lynn Lorenzen is the greatest ever been. The kids playing around her, and it's just been a great year.
Coach, I want to mention to you that we've been talking about Lynn Lorenzen all season long, but this has been a six-player-plus effort. This has been a basketball team that had some destiny stamped all over it, isn't it?
Yeah, it has. You know, we set this goal last year. We got beat, and we had a lot of things that happened that set that up, and this was a hungry basketball team, and they were destined to be state champions. They're a great group of kids. They spent all summer playing ball together and lifting weights and things, and they deserve to be a state champion.
Chuck, the cupboard is not bare. You've got a lot of talent coming back. You got a dynasty going here or what now?
Well, I hope so. I hope so. It's a lot of fun. I hope we can keep it up.
Just 47 girls in school at Ventura High School, and you've got most of them involved in the basketball program. What's coming up in the future for Chuck Bredlow and the Lady Vikes?
Well, we're going to enjoy this for a while. I'll tell you what. Then we're going to get back to work again.
The celebrating starts tomorrow in Ventura, and then, of course, we have softball practice come Monday, don't we?
No, we don't. No, we don't. We're going to take it off for a while.
Chuck, our congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
We're going to try to move over here to Lynn Lorenzen. And Lynn, would you step in, and our congratulations to you on one great basketball season, one great high school career that comes to a close tonight.
Thank you very much. This is a great way to end my high school career. My teammates are great. I love them.
The Naismith Award was something you weren't expecting.
I was not expecting it, and that's a great honor. I'm very proud.
You're a terrific representative of Ventura High School and of girls basketball in the state of Iowa. Any thoughts as you close down this career?
Well, I just want to say that I couldn't do it without these guys right here. It was a team effort, and it takes a lot of practice, and it takes goals. And if you set them, you can do it. Another thing is, hi to everyone in Arizona. Thanks for watching.
Everybody watching in Arizona, Lynn, congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations to Ventura. Congratulations to Lynn Lorenzen and a fine performance for Ventura. Ventura winning tonight against Southeast Polk to claim the 6-on-6 championship. A little bit earlier, Western Dubuque won the championship in five-player competition. Certainly our congratulations. It's been a great week of basketball here at Vets Auditorium. Want to thank you especially for joining us. Our thanks to Bob Scarpino, Carlos Fernandez, our producer-director, and, of course, our fine sponsor for 28 years now, Land O'Lakes. Thanks for joining us, Vets Auditorium in Des Moines.
She takes one thrilling home. Of next.